The invention of the microscope opened up the world of very minute living organisms called microorganisms. They are everywhere, from the soil we walk on, the air we breathe, the water we drink, and even right now, there is a whole colony of microorganisms living on your face. They are also inside all living organisms and can either benefit or harm them, depending on their type. Types of microorganisms include viruses, bacteria, fungi, algae, and protozoa. This time, let's study one of them, viruses. Viruses are the smallest microorganisms that can cause fatal diseases. Observing at their nanometer size, compared to micrometers for bacteria, necessitates the use of an electron microscope. While they are lacking in size, they are certainly not lacking in numbers. Viruses are the most abundant microbe on Earth, which number is greater than all the other microbes combined. Viruses are not considered as living because they do not have any protoplasm. They also cannot feed, respire, excrete, or grow. Their metabolism and self-replication abilities are only possible once they're inside a host cell, the living cell in which the viruses take over. For this hijacking ability, they are called obligate parasites. The virus is, in fact, a pretty simple being compared to other single-cell microorganisms. A virus is made up of one nucleic acid that can either be an RNA or DNA. Some viruses also possess their own enzymes, such as reverse transcriptase, covered by a protein coat called capsid. Lie on the surface, the spike proteins or antigens are the first to come in contact with the receptor on the host cells. If they match, the virus can enter the cell as a whole or has its membrane fused together with the cell's membrane, so its contents can be inserted into the host cell. From there, they can start the hijacking process. Despite their relatively small sizes, they are pretty resilient. The COVID-causing coronavirus can survive temperatures as low as minus 80 degrees Celsius and can survive an hour of heating in 60 degrees Celsius. We need to increase the temperature by another 10 degrees to kill them in the same time period. Viruses are also resistant to antibiotics, as they have different structures compared to bacteria. However, some disinfectants, such as chlorine or phenol, can be used to kill them effectively by altering their coatings. Non-ionizing radiation, such as UV rays, cause pyrimidine dimer formation of the virus's DNA or RNA, while ionizing radiation, like X-rays, cause lethal break of the viral genome. We can classify around 10 to the power of 31st of the total viruses in existence into groups, depending on the criteria that we use. Morphology. Using this criteria, they can be filamentous, icosahedral, spherical, or head or tail. Genome and replication properties. The aforementioned DNA and RNA viruses can be divided further using the Baltimore classification. Host. Viruses can claim animal cells, plant cells, or bacteria as their host. Mode of transmission. Some of their modes of transmissions are respiratory, vertical, and zoonotic infection. The taxonomy of viruses divides them into even more groups: 2,000 species, 287 genera, 37 families, and 3 orders. Should we get into that later on? It would be tedious, but also amazing to realize that there are numerous different types of these simple microbes. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.